What you have here is an ice skater rotating at a slow initial angular speed omega I, and her hands are outstretched. Now, when she pulls her arms and legs in, what really is happening is that her rotational inertia is reducing from its initial value I initial to a smaller value I final, simply because you see her body mass has now moved closer to the axis of rotation. And when this happens, what we find is that her rotational speed increases from omega initial to omega final. Okay, so how do we explain this increase in angular velocity using the law of conservation of angular momentum? So first off, we can see that no net external torque has acted on the ice skater, and therefore the angular momentum of the ice skater about the rotation axis has to remain constant, or I initial times omega initial should equal I final times omega final. So what has happened here is that as the moment of inertia of the skater reduced when she pulled her hands in, her angular velocity increased, so that this product remained the same as before. That is, the initial and the final angular momentum remained the same in accordance with the law of conservation of angular momentum. And this precise control over rotational motion is what allows top ice skaters to perform at the highest level, executing breathtaking spins with incredible speeds and precision.